Hello everyone, I'm Kimberly and he's Kaishan, and today we are going to be presenting about the student focus system, which is the project we invented. This project will help the teachers community. Let us start off by telling you a story. Ben is a gamer who spends most of his free time playing games. He is someone who never likes focusing in class, even when in school. And during this recent MCO, since neither of his parents nor teachers were by his side to control what he was doing, he uses these school hours to play games, and as a result, he hasn't been doing well in exams, and his parents and teachers are extremely worried. In this short story, we are able to identify three problems which we have highlighted here in yellow.
Here's the proof. This is a survey that is reported on April 16, 2020, and it states that more than half the students are not even tuning into online class. And this is another survey that is reported on 11th of June, 2020, and it states that students want physical lessons. Current solution, which the teacher can try to call out the students in the classes, but most of the time they will not respond. So that's why we invented the student focus system.
This student focus system, which is the project we invented, is a device that is controlled by the teacher that will play music or sound, and it also gives instructions.
The teacher will have this app, and the student will have this device. The teacher can choose whichever message he or she would like to send to the student. From the list here, we have pay attention, break time, submit homework on Google Classroom, on camera, good job, and as a reward, listen to music. During online classes, whenever the teacher realizes that one of his students is not participating in a class activity or discussion, he or she could ask the student to turn on their camera by pressing on the on camera button. The student will then receive the message they sent. To off it, the student will need to press on the push button, and the visual message and sound will no longer be displayed or heard. The teacher could also send a message of motivation to the student, which they can do it by pressing on the good job button on their app. The student will then receive a message saying good job, keep it up, and also hear a short music which is being played. To off it, the student will need to do the exact same thing, which is to press on the push button. The teacher could also reward the student with a song. To do this, the teacher will need to press on the listen to song button on their app. The student will instantly receive the message that was sent by the teacher. The student will also hear a song which is being played by the speaker in their device. Our app also allows the teacher to type any message he or she would like to send to the student. For example, the teacher could choose to say calling you next to the student. And when she presses send, the student will also receive the message they sent.
So why we choose to solve this is because now a very common worldwide problem and classes have to be online. So it's a struggle for teachers to have the students cooperate. So it's very important to address this issue. The advantages are that it's easy to use, which there are six buttons, which each button has their respective sound. Attention grabbing, because it plays loud sound and displays messages on the LCD, which the student needs to press a button in order to deactivate it. And it also doesn't distract other students, since the teacher will only communicate with the student that he or she wants to talk to, and it doesn't stop the class.
We have five ideas for our future upgrade. The first one will be using a Wi-Fi module, which is the ESP8266. And the reason for this is because this Wi-Fi module has a longer range communication as compared to a Bluetooth module. But the only downside to using this Wi-Fi module is, unlike the Bluetooth module, the teacher will know if the device is not turned on, as the option to connect to this Bluetooth module will be grey out and therefore can't be connected. However, when using a Wi-Fi module, the teacher will not know if the device is powered on, as the connection is to the router to be powered. Our second idea will be using an Arduino Nano, as it is much smaller as compared to an Arduino Uno. Thirdly, we also plan to make this device battery powered, so it can not only be used using an USB cable but also using battery. In this case, that will mean that this device doesn't necessarily need to be connected to a power source like from a computer or power bank to work. We also plan to expand usability by building an interface for student-to-student communication, so students can communicate with each other using this. And the last one will be allowing teachers to conduct polls using the app, whereby they can post a yes or no question to be answered by the student and get replies from there.
Let me just run down the components used. So we have breadboard, Arduino Uno, KD05 Bluetooth module, jumper wire, LCD screen, USB cable, transistor, push button, speaker, and a brown-green-brown resistor.
The two softwares that we used were Arduino and MIT App Inventor. So here are our learnings and inspirations. We learn how to present our idea confidently, which is the most important thing in this project. We learn how to use and code an LCD, how to be united as a team, how to generate possible solutions to a problem, how to simplify the wires on our breadboard, and how to expand our creativity. This is the end of our presentation. Thank you for listening and have a nice day.